Sesame Street. How to get to Sesame Street.
Oh, hi there. Hi, I'm glad you're here. I was just thinking about when I was a baby. I didn't go out and get food for myself. Someone had to feed me. I sat at home all day with my little head turned up and my beak wide open like this. And then I would cheep like this. Beep, 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 beep. And I would wait and wait for my mommy to come in and drop something interesting to eat into my mouth. Beep, beep, beep. Did you do that when you were a baby? I was just kidding. I know you didn't. Why, some babies can't eat solid food like I did. They drink milk from bottles or from their mommies. That's what we're going to see right now.
Hi there, Bert. What you got there?
Ah, oh, hey, Ernie. I just wrapped this present here.
A present? A present, Bert? Oh, wow, what a surprise. Oh, boy, am I surprised, Bert. Gee, you just shouldn't have done it. What is it?
Oh, Ernie. Oh, no. See, what it
no,
is...
No, don't
see,
tell
Ernie.
Me. Don't tell me what it is. You'll spoil the surprise. Let me just guess what it is. I know, but it's a new football.
Oh, no, Ernie. See,
you just knew I wanted a new football, didn't you, Bert?
Wrong.
Just
wrong,
one second,
Ernie.
Bert. I'll be
see,
right
no,
back.
I'm trying to explain to you. See, you got to... Ernie. Ernie.
Go you northwestern to pull. Okay, I got my football helmet on. I'm all ready to open my new football.
No.
No?
It's not a football.
It's not a football.
No, take that silly helmet off. It is not
well,
a football helmet.
Not a football.
Look,
okay, don't tell me what it is. I will guess what it is if it's not a football.
Okay.
It is.
Okay, I've had it.
It's the right size for a cake.
No, no.
It's
Ernie,
a cake, Bert.
No, Ernie,
I knew
I'm
that's what it is.
You.
It's a cake. Just one second, Bert. I'll be right back.
Oh, Ernie. Ernie, look, it is not. Okay, that does it. Wow. Ernie!
Okay, I got my napkin on. I have my fork, and I'm all ready to eat my cake. So.
Ernie, hold it.
What?
It is not a cake.
Oh.
Ernie,
not a cake,
old
huh?
pal. Ernie, old pal.
I'll just keep guessing.
No,
then,
you
huh?
don't have to keep on guessing, Ernie. You
well,
don't
no, don't,
have to
don't,
keep it all
don't
because...
tell me what it is, Bert, because you'll spoil the surprise. I'll just guess it, okay? Now, don't
Ernie.
Worry. Hey, I know what it must be. It must be a new lamp to put by my bed, right, Bert?
No,
so
Ernie,
I can
Ernie.
Read. I knew that. Okay, just one second.
Ernie,
I'll be right back, Bert.
Don't go.
Hold
don't
on.
Go away. Ernie, I'm trying to tell you. What was that? Ernie.
Okay.
Ernie, look, I'm trying to
I got, this is going to be the first book that I'm going to read with my brand new lamp, Bert.
No, it's not.
It's not?
It's not a lamp.
It's not a lamp?
No. It's not a lamp. It's not a football. It's not a cake. I am trying to tell you. Now, please stop guessing.
You're right, Bert. You're absolutely right.
Finally.
Because if I guess what it is, I'll spoil the surprise, right?
Right.
I'll just open it.
Well, not really. See what it is. Ernie, please don't open it. Ernie, you don't know what you're doing. Look, you don't understand. Now stop it. I'll try and explain to you. See, what that present is, Ernie...
Hey. Gee, It's a hat.
Yeah.
With a veil.
Yeah.
And flowers on top, too.
Right. Right.
Well, gee, Bert, I really am surprised.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, you know who else is going to be surprised, Aaron?
Who?
My Aunt Matilda.
She is?
Yeah, when she finds out that you opened the surprise present I bought for her!
Gee, Bert, did you buy one of these for her, too?
Comes in its own special size. I guess it can be measured by where you put your eyes. It's so big when you're close, it looks smaller back a bit. That's about the size of it. That's about the size where you put your eyes. That's about the size of it. The big becomes the little when you see it back a bit. The huge becomes a dinky, which is just the opposite of the larger that gets smaller. It never seems to quit. That's about the size of it. That's about the size where you put your eyes. That's about the size of it. Let the big become the little, that's the way it seems to go. That they make up a larger thing is something good to know. It's nice to know that though we're small, there's always room to grow. And that's about the size of it. That's about the size where you put your eyes. That's about the size of it.
You know that I am called the Count, because I really love to count. Sometimes I sit and count all day, but sometimes I get carried away. I count slowly, 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 getting faster. Once I start in counting, it's very hard to stop. Hey, faster, faster, it is so exciting. I could count forever, count until I drop. One, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two. I love counting, whatever the amount. One, two, three, four, hey, 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 hey. One, two, three, four, one, two, that's a song of the count. I count the spiders on the wall. I count the cobwebs in the hall. I count the candles on the shelf. When I'm alone, I count myself. Oh, yeah. I count slowly, 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 getting faster. Once I start in counting, it's very hard to stop. Faster, faster, it is so exciting. I could count forever, count until I drop. One, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two. I love counting, whatever the amount. One, two, three, four, hey, yeah, 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 hey, yeah, yeah, yeah. One, two, three, four, one, two, that's his song. The count.
Bald eagle. These are the curly highways. song. Now he's looking at the big cliff with the road next to it. The bridge with a river going under it. A curly road.
A funny one too.
Yeah. Oh, now he's in his nest again.
You know what this is here? Hmm? It telephone. Yeah. T-E-L-E-P-H-O-N-E. Back there, the E. Telephone. Yeah. A really nice thing, too. Yeah. You know why? Well, see, it lets you talk to anyone else in the world who has a telephone, too. Yeah. You listen here, put this to ear, and put this to mouth, and then you can talk and listen. Oh, that's terrific.
Hey, Maria. Hey, Cookie. Gracias. Yeah. Thank you for watching the store, man.
Okay.
Hi, Cookie.
What are you talking about?
Hmm?
What were you doing?
Oh, me just talking about telephone. Not good? Hmm?
Good? No, I don't know if it's so good.
Oh, yeah, believe me, telephone terrific.
Oh, yeah?
Mm.
I don't know, not bad, but needs a little something. What do you think, Maria?
Let me try. It's good, but it needs a little bit of sofrito.
Algo de salsa, ¿verdad? Sí.
Me no understand this.
The crow and the pitcher. A crow was so thirsty that he could barely talk. When he came to a pitcher, which once had been full of water. But when he put his beak into the pitcher, he found that only a little bit of water was left inside it. Try and try as he might, he was not able to reach far enough down to get the water. He tried to break the pitcher. He tried to turn it over, but he wasn't strong enough to do it. Just as he was about to give up in despair, he had an idea. He picked up a pebble and dropped it into the pitcher. Then he took another pebble and dropped that into the pitcher. He kept dropping pebbles into the pitcher, and the water got higher and higher. And finally, the water reached the top of the pitcher. Then, sitting on the handle, he drank and drank the water until he wasn't thirsty anymore. The moral of The Crow and the Pitcher is, you can figure out lots of ways to do anything you really have to do.
We sell at the auction pigs, sheep, sometimes chickens and hens, cows, calves. They bring their animals here to us, and they let us sell them to other farmers so that they can raise either dairy cattle or sometimes beef cattle. And this is the way to sell them to other, you know, so that other people can have them.
Here's a pig, a pair of pigs, so much a piece, and take two. Who'll be 25 a piece to go, boys? Who's in 26? Mom, 26, you want to dig a little bit of mama? I've been 25 a piece, and 26, we want to dig a little bit of 26, you want to dig a little bit of 26, the mommy all in all, and 25 a piece, but 26. So 25 times 2, 25 a piece. He's got a nice horse right there. Get on over to my charm, go shoot him, go wrong, get on with your friend, go friend, bye. I'm at 170, 175. There's kind of a fine horse right there. 175, we've been 100 and 175. Mama, 172 to have, a do to have, a do to have, a do to have, a mama, 172 to have, you want to buy a 172 to have. Safe horse right there is tested and ready to go anywhere in the country. Tennessee Walker and Morgan Prop. Freddie, 172 to have, 172 to have, you want a 172 to have, a 172 to have, a 172 to have. So, $170, $170. Smitty's a buyer at 170. All right, now, let's sell dairy cows. 500, 175, 175, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165, 165,
Frog here, and today I'm going to talk about the
Hey, Froggy baby!
Oh no, not again. Missed me!
Oh, Froggy!
Yes, indeed.
Oh, I wanted to give you little pats.
I remember those little pats. Hey, listen, Grover.
You move fast.
Now that you're here.
Yes.
Would you like to help me talk about the number 5?
I would love to help you, Froggy.
I figured you would.
Good. Okay. What do I do?
Take a look back there. You see that big pile of blocks back there?
Oh, yes.
See that big pile?
What fun.
Okay. Now, I would like you to go back to that pile of blocks.
Yes.
And bring me 5 blocks. Okay?
Say again.
5 blocks.
Froggy?
What's the matter?
I do not know what 5 blocks is.
Well, you don't know how to count 5 blocks?
Don't rub it in.
Well, how many blocks can you count, Grover?
1.
Okay. Go back there and bring me 1 block.
Oh, do I do that very well?
Okay, do it.
Okay, here goes 1 block.
Okay. Now, Grover will go get 1 block, okay? How are you doing? Cerise.
Cerise?
Yeah.
I think I got the yellow one.
It doesn't matter, Grover.
Okay, here we go.
Okay.
Here we go.
Got the 1 block?
That's it. Okay.
Okay.
That was very easy.
Good. Now go back and bring me 1 more block.
You got 1 block.
No, go bring 1 more block.
Oh. Okay.
Okay.
This is a long distance to travel for blocks.
Now you will notice that Grover has gone 1 time, and we have here 1 block.
Okay,
see that? 1 block.
Here's another one. Okay,
just put it down there.
Here we go.
Good. Okay, now listen, Grover.
Yes.
Go back there and bring me 1 more block.
I brought you 1.
Yes, 1
right.
more.
Okay.
Go.
I go.
Right. Now you see, Grover has now gone 2 times to the block pile, and we have right here 2 blocks. See there? 1, 2. Okay?
It's a long way to travel for blocks.
Just put it down there, Grover.
I did.
Okay, now go get me 1 more block.
Froggy, I'm getting tired.
Well, just 1 more block.
Yeah, I did 1 more block.
Okay. Grover has now gone 3 times to the block pile, and we now have 3 blocks here. So you got 1, 2, 3. That's 3 blocks. Okay?
Oh, I'm coming.
Okay, put it down right over here, Grover.
My feet's getting tired. Okay, there.
Okay, good. Now go back there and bring me 1 more block, Grover.
1 more block.
Right on.
Oh, Froggy, I'm so tired.
Okay. Grover has now gone 4 times to the block pile, and we now have here 4 blocks. You see, we got 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay?
I'm coming here.
Okay. Okay,
here
just
go.
Put it down there.
Okay.
Good.
Okay.
Now.
I now get another block.
No. Grover, come back here. Come back here. Now listen, Grover.
Yeah.
Tell me. How many times did you go to the block pile?
5 times.
Right. You went 5 times to the block pile.
Yeah.
And so what have you got?
Sore back.
No, Grover.
Tired feet.
No. You've got 5 blocks.
So?
See, you went 5 times to the block pile. Each time you brought back 1 block. So you now have 5 blocks.
5 blocks. I did it.
Right.
Oh, boy.
So now you understand about 5 blocks?
I understand. I certainly do.
Good. Now we're going to talk about 100, Grover. Go back there and bring me 1 block, would you?
Turtle. in my hand.
What kind of a surprise?
Guess.
Is this a butterfly?
Oh, no, it's not a butterfly.
It's a candy bar.
Let's see. Nope, it's not a candy bar.
I give up. What is it?
Watch. It's an elephant. Surprise!
That was my next guess.
Oh, quick, please. You have some place I can plug in?
I got it. Don't worry. It's taken care of.
Is it plugged in?
Yes, it's all right. Oh, there it is.
Thank you.
Good.
What was that?
Hi, Mr. Hoover. What's the matter?
David, the strangest thing happened.
What?
A guy rushed in here, gave me his electric wire, told me to plug it in, and I plugged it in, yeah. And then it was all excited, yeah. And he ran right out again.
Okay. And so, I mean, maybe he had some business outside. You like, maybe he was working like a workman. You know, he had to use a drill. Did he look like Biff or Sully?
No. He didn't look like Biff or Sully.
No.
What
did he look like?
Only he was round, and he was furry, and he had some strange eyes.
Strange eyes?
Yes.
Strange, real strange?
Yes.
Well, maybe we ought to find this guy. I know. Let's follow the cord. Let's follow the wire. And we'll find him. We'll find him. Hello? Hi? Hey, you!
Shh. I'm glued.
He certainly is.
I'm a fella who, let you use my outlet.
Yeah, that's him.
That's okay.
Well, let me ask you something. Are you, like, moving into the neighborhood?
Not moving in. Moved in. This is it. This is where I live.
Right here, on the street?
Why not? My set's here. I'm here. What else do I need?
Well, since you're going to be right here and be neighbors, I think we ought to get to know each other. My name is Mr. Hooper, and this is my assistant, David.
Hi. What's your name?
I'm Telly Monster.
Telly Monster?
Someone asked for an N here, and I don't know where it goes. Wait a minute. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, R, J, K, L, M, N, O, P. That's where it belongs. Let's hear it for capital N. Yay, yay, capital N. We like you so well, we'll say it again. Yay, yay, capital N.
Listen, I'll tell you a story old and true. Now Casey McPhee, the engineer, got this train through. He faced the toughest duty an engineer could do. But he was brave and unafraid, and he got this train through. Through, he got the train through. Through.
Me got the train, yeah.
Train was carrying moo cows and milk and ice cream too. There were six cars filled with cookies and a tank of chocolate goo. The stuff was for the parties that the kids would have all year. And getting that train through the narrow pass was the job of the engineer.
Through, 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 he'll get that train through. Through, 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 he'll get that train through.
Oh, this train filled with stuff we love to eat. And children all waiting for it on other side of narrow, dangerous mountain pass. And me responsible for whole train. Me must get train through.
The track and covered it with snow. The snow was deep, the track was blocked, there was nowhere he could go. Casey knew the train was filled with things he loved to eat, but Casey knew his duty and would not admit defeat.
Through, 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 he'll get that train through. Through, 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 he'll get the train through.
Oh, this very hard choice. Track covered with snow. If me stay here and not try to get through pass, me stuck here, all alone with six carloads of cookies and ice cream. All alone, with nobody watching. Oh, me getting hungry. Me getting very hungry. Oh, maybe it not too bad if me eat some cookies. Wait! What me doing? It'd be very bad if me eat cookies. Me must get train through!
Yes, Casey was a hero, and his duty he could see. Without the cookies and the milk, no parties could there be. The kids would be unhappy, so Casey raised his head.
Me forget about the cookies and eat the snow instead.
The story of Nancy the Nanny Goat is brought to you by the letter N. Nancy the Nanny Goat lived north of Nantucket. Nancy had a pet, a nice nightingale.
I am a nightingale.
Now, Nancy was a nincompoop because around her neck she wore a narrow napkin. One night in November at 9:09, she got a notion to visit a nutty nanny goat farm.
Numbskull, nitwit, nincompoop
were some of the nasty names the other nanny goats called her as she sat nibbling on her nails. The granny nanny goat noticed Nancy and said,
Nancy, don't be a ninny. Never nibble on your nails.
Nancy became nervous. She took off the narrow napkin and put on a nifty necklace. Instead of nibbling her nails, she started to notice noodles. Granny nanny goat noticed Nancy and said,
Nanny goats who nibble on their nails and notice noodles are nutty.
This story of Nancy the Nanny Goat was brought to you by the letter N.
I'm telling you that that guy has a real weird lifestyle. I mean, all he does, he sits in front of that television, you know, and he watches it like,
no.
I'm telling you, that's serious.
Oh, well, you know, he's new in the neighborhood. Perhaps he's shy.
That's not it.
Yes, yes, I think that's what it is. You know how it was when I first came. Why don't we go ask him to play baseball?
Okay, all right, all right. Hi, Telly Monster.
Shh, shh, shh. I'm glued.
This is Olivia.
No, this is Lucy.
Reruns, right. How about some baseball?
Sure. What channel is it on?
It's not on any channel.
Then where is it?
It's in the park.
How far away is that?
It's only 4 blocks right down there.
Oh, I might be able to make it. Oh, no. I guess not.
Why not?
My cord's too short. My set will only travel 3 blocks.
Heathcliff, would you tell it to move? I have to vacuum my room.
I'm not going to wake him, Sheila, but let me vacuum it for you. I know all about vacuum cleaners.
What's inside them, Heathcliff?
Well, in this one, I hear the whir of a propeller. That means there's a tiny helicopter making trips from one end of the vacuum cleaner to the other to pick up dirt and carry it back to the vacuum cleaner.
That's very clever, Heathcliff. Inside the vacuum cleaner, there's an electrical storm going on. The electricity makes all the dirt jump up and stick to the inside of the vacuum cleaner. Excuse me, it...
Put me down. I'll tell you how a vacuum cleaner really works. The vacuum cleaner is a wonderful invention which does the same job as a broom, except it uses air to pick up dust and dirt instead of straw bristles. The vacuum cleaner has a fan inside of it, which whirs around when you plug the machine in. The fan pulls the air in through the hose and into a paper bag. All the dust and dirt in front of the hose gets sucked into the bag with the air. When the bag gets full of dirt, you take the full bag out and put in a clean, empty bag. Now your vacuum cleaner is ready to clean again. If your vacuum cleaner looks like this, the fan is right here. The air sucks the dirt on the floor into the vacuum cleaner and into this big bag. The bag is then emptied by opening one end and pouring the dirt out.
Sheila, would you tell it to move? I have to vacuum my room.
The it really knows how it works.
Yesterday was bright, or yesterday was gray, but all I know is how I feel today. Yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Whether they bring pleasure or sorrow, time is something no one can borrow. Yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Today is not too late, today's the only
I think it's about time that you put away these toys.
Oh, well, Bert, I didn't bring all these toys out here. You brought some of these toys out here.
Well, yeah, but you brought most of the toys out here.
Okay, Bert. Well, I tell you what, I'll put most of the toys away, okay?
Okay. Okay, and I'll pick up the rest later, okay?
Okay, fine, Bert.
Good. Bye-bye.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. If I could just group these toys into groups, and I'll put away a group of toys. How about that? Tell you what, I'll put away all the fire engines. Now, here's one fire engine here. Let's see, are there any other fire engines here? Don't see any other. No other fire engines. Okay. So I'll put away the fire engine. Oh, but there's still an awful lot of toys left there. I guess I better put away one more group of toys. Tell you what, I'll put away all the big toys. All the big toys. Let's see, not a very big toy. No. I don't see any other big toys. So here's a big toy. Look at this big toy here. I'll put away the fire engine. Well, there's still a lot of toys there. I think I better put away another group of toys. I'll put away all the red toys. How about that? All the toys that are red. That toy's kind of pinkish, but it's certainly not red. You're not red, are you? No. Red toys. Red toys. Here's a red toy. Look at that. The fire engine. Okay, I'll put away the fire engine. Oh, but there's still a lot of toys there. I better put away one more group of toys. I'll put away all the toys with wheels. How about that? All the toys with wheels. Rubber Ducky, do you have wheels? Nope, he doesn't have wheels. Horse have wheels? Nope, horse doesn't have wheels. Hey, here's a toy with wheels. The fire engine. Look at the wheels. Everybody see the wheels on the fire engine? Yep, there are the wheels right there. Okay, I'll put away the fire engine. Still too many toys here. I better put away one more group of toys. Put away all the toys with ladders. How about that? All the toys with ladders. Any ladders on the trombone? Nope. No ladders. Here's a toy with ladders. The fire engine. Okay, I'll put away the fire engine. I'm certainly putting away a lot of toys.
Hey, Ernie?
Yes, Bert?
Hey, Ernie.
What?
Hey, I thought you were going to put most of the toys away.
Oh, I'm just about to, Bert.
Yeah?
I'll tell you what. I'll tell you which toys I'm going to put away, all right?
Okay.
Now, I'm going to put away all the fire engines.
Good.
And all the big toys.
Yeah.
And all the red toys. And all the toys with wheels. And all the toys with ladders. Okay, Bert?
Yeah.
Okay.
M.
M.
Hi. I have two letters here. M and N. Now they look very similar and they sound similar. M. Mmm. N. Mmm. First, let's talk about the letter N. Hi, Barkley. Look, he's got a newspaper. Newspaper. Hear the N sound in front of the newspaper? Look at your nose. Show them your cold nose. Yes. And nuzzle. Yes, that starts with the N. Oh, I have another one, too. It's no, Barkley. No. Good boy. Let's talk about the letter M now. Okay? Let's go over and ask Telly Monster. Monster. Okay. Telly Monster. We're talking about words that start with the letter M. Do you think you can tell us a few words?
Mr. Rogers. MASH. Muppet Show. Mary Tyler Moore. Million Dollar Movie. Meet the Press. Masterpiece Theater. Match Game. Mickey Mouse.
Hi there. I, as you can see, am a mouse. Mouse begins with this letter, M. Now I'm going to show you something else that begins with M. Mud. Uh-oh. And we don't want to forget the most important word that begins with M. Mother. Bye-bye.
Near. Far. Near. Far. Near. Far.
Near. Far.
Near. Far.
Near.
And now we take you to Kermit the Frog for another fast-breaking news story.
Hi there, Kermit the Frog here for Sesame Street News. And today, I am at the bedside of the world-famous Sleeping Beauty. That is indeed Sleeping Beauty right there, sound asleep. And she has been asleep for 100 years. Yeah, 100 years, folks. And today we're expecting the Prince Charming, to come and wake her up with a magic kiss. And, hark, I think I hear the Prince's horse approaching now. Yes, look. See, way over there, far away from the Princess, is Prince Charming. Uh-huh. And now he is coming near the sleeping Princess. And he's even coming nearer now. Look at that. Now he's about as near as he can possibly get. And in 1 second, this is the magic moment, folks, we will actually see him give her the magic kiss and break the spell. Here he goes now.
With your beauty, you broke my heart. With this kiss, I break your spell.
Folks, you've just seen history in the making. The Prince's kiss did indeed wake up the sleeping Princess, but it changed her also into a beautiful young frog.
A frog?
Hi there, handsome.
Oh, well, hello there.
Oh, say, where can we get some breakfast? You know, I'm starved. I've been asleep for 100 years.
Yeah, well, listen, there's a nice little... Well, come on right down this way here. There's a nice little delicatessen down the block here.
Nice.
Sure,
yeah.
Come on.
I'm really hungry, you know, and maybe after.
Sure, well, listen, come on, sweetheart. Oh, hey, listen, we return you now to your regularly scheduled program, huh?
Catch a few flies.
Sure, okay.
Stop.
Timber! Timber!
Hi, Harvey Kneeslapper here. Oh, I got a great trick today. See, what's going to happen is the next guy comes along here, I'm going to say, give me five. And and then he's going to stick out his hand and slap my hand. And see this here? I got a buzzer on my hand. And as soon as he slaps my hand, it's going to go... That's going to surprise him so much. It's going to be so funny. Oh, here comes somebody now. Hi. Give me five.
Say what?
I say, give me five.
Okay. Five.
Oh, no.
What's wrong?
I've lost my pet.
Where'd you lose it?
I don't know.
Don't you remember?
What's remember?
Remembering is like walking backwards through your mind. You get to see what you've done before. When did you lose your pet?
Yesterday.
Then all you have to do is walk backwards through your mind to yesterday. Can you do that?
Sure.
Okay. Where were you yesterday?
I remember. I went to the park.
And what were you doing in the park?
Having a picnic. I remember I left my pet at the park.
I don't see a pet anywhere.
He's here, all right.
That's him.
Come on, George. Let's go home.
Your knee is kind of roundish like an orange or an egg. You'll find it sticking out there in the center of your leg. It bends right in the middle when you want a rubber jump. It's a funny kind of, lumpy kind of, knobby kind of bump.
Oh. A, B, C, D, 1, 2, 3. Let's all sing a song about a knee.
A joint that holds your body to your arm, and everybody's got them in the city, on the farm. They're useful when you want to wave hello or wave goodbye, and if you want to wiggle them, it's easy if you try.
Oh, A, B, C, D, when you are older, you'll still sing a song about a shoulder.
The ankle can be found at the beginning of your foot, and when you're getting dressed, it's in the sock in which it's put. The ankle is important if you want to jump or run, and if anybody kicks you there, it isn't any fun.
Oh, A, B, C, your pink piggy bankle help you rhyme a silly word like ankle.
When you think about your body and you think of all its parts, don't only think of eyes and ears, of noses, toes, and hearts. Just think of things that bend, that move, that help both you and me to walk and run and jump and play the ankle, shoulder, knee.
Oh, A, B, C, D, W, X, Y, Z. That's it for the ankle, the shoulder, and the knee.
Five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five. 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 M.
A prairie dog.
Would you like to see something strange and amazing? Well, just watch this. First, here I am, standing on the sidewalk. And now, one, two, three, four, five, six. Six, and here I am, at the top of the stairs. And now, watch the amazing part. This is six, five, four, three, two, one, and here I am back again on the sidewalk. Isn't that wonderful how it works? Want to see me do it again? Two, three, four, five, six.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters M and N, and by the number five. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.